here at this lab. Okay, so I do the day-to-day running of this lab, and we try to encourage programs and try to see programs for innovation and stuff like that. Okay, later I will give you all, after this whole talk, we'll give you all a tour of the lab, and then after that we can go together with Daniel and Kenneth up onto the rooftop to look at the farm, the current state of the farm. Okay, so now what we are talking about is this this project that we did with the Raitong Organic Farm in Thailand. Okay, so it's a organic rice farm. They farm organic rice. Okay, and the problem with this farm is that they have, every time they send out, during transportation, some packet of rice will go missing. Okay, so this is like, okay, so first thing is that it's not so much, what we're talking about is not so much about the technology or we're not technology expert and stuff like that. In fact, I'm not an engineer at all. Okay, so I'm a hobbyist. So what we believe here is that we enable people to, non-engineers to make stuff. Okay, we are makers and we hack stuff together and stuff like that. Okay, so we thought of this book, this idea we set together, and then we decided to say, okay, why not try a high-tech approach to make a sort of a high-tech alarm or theft kind of anti-theft system. So we came up with UHF RFID. Okay, so basically the system is very simple. I'll most probably bore you all to death with the detail because I think you all already know it. Okay, so basically what we do is we count the numbers of packs that's tacked onto the rice packets. So then it actually locks onto a micro SD card, and then through a GSM radio, okay, then it sends data back to if there's some missing parts, some missing text when it's counted. This thing can count how many? 600, 700 texts per second?
About 150 texts per second.
Oh, 150 texts.
The antenna's over there. That's the antenna.
Yeah. So we run through, we run through a certain kind of like problem like anybody else. Okay, we try to get a back. So we started off with one module, the RFID module. Okay, and then we realized that we need a high gain antenna for the range to cover the whole back of the lorry and stuff like that. So we end up buying more stuff and then in the end put this together. Okay, so it works very well, except it only penetrates the first layer of the boxes, so it doesn't go through the second layer. So in fact, so our idea of high-tech technology, as a maker, we always think that, oh, if we can do this, it will be cool, but then after that, but the actual fact, it didn't work. It only worked on the first, second layer, right?
Yeah.
Okay, yes, with radio frequency penetration is always an issue. So then they think sort of a variety of other way of doing it. Okay, Ben, I didn't go to the farm. Actually, Ben and Arvin, they went to the actual farm. Okay, I was here in comfort of the aircon and all that while they did all the hard work. Okay, so in the end, so they go back during on their trip there, they decided to go back to the drawing board and decide to make a tripwire instead. Okay, so they have this whole lorry. Okay, and then they have a tarp over it. Right, you have a canvas over it. Right. And then the canvas is rigged with some tripwire. So if you open up the canvas, it will register that somebody opened it up. So then we because it's actually never mind.
I can share a bit here.
Yeah.
So this is the top of the truck. Okay, which is somewhere there outside. So it's very simple because kind of last minute. We actually just finished this, like 20 minutes before the truck gotta go. It's a rush. So we just tape it to the railing on the side here. And these are ropes attached to the box. the boxes. So the idea is that because the boxes are stacked, right? So if I take the bottom layer, the box will drop. And when the box drops, it will trigger this tripwire. That's our simple idea. So that's what we did, yeah. So they will, that's what we did upstairs.
Okay, let me save someone.
Everything was just tape.
Let me go back a bit. So one of the technical challenges that we faced was that the RFID was randomly reading text all over the place. So there's like text that are very near the reader, you keep reading that over and over again. Then only once in a long while you read like a very far away text. Yeah, so we managed to come up with our own library function to overcome this. Basically, we just if we see a new text, just put it in the array. It's the same. If it's already in an array, don't put it in an array. Alright, so just then after that, we give it like 10 seconds. After 10 seconds, you have counted, you went through about 1,500 texts. So surely you should have counted, you went through all. So then after 10 seconds, you count the size of the array, you count the number of unique texts. We needed to do that because we needed to keep track of the number of boxes at the back of the truck, right? So let's say there are 10 boxes. If one is removed, right, one of the texts removed, then we know there's 9 left. So we know that it's stolen. So we needed this function. Yeah.
So basically the objective of the owners is just to try to find out what happened for insurance claim, because they can't claim insurance, they can't prove that there's theft actually happens. I mean, I guess in Singapore it's easier to test, but to prove, but then in Thailand it's very, very difficult. Okay, and then the truck got no choke point, so you can't have like a choke point entry to check on what goes in and out of the truck and stuff like that. So it's a wide open space with an antenna, and we tried to capture everything, and then it basically didn't work. Okay, so the tripwire works to a certain extent. Did they ever find out what happened?
Okay, during the actual truck journey, no boxes were stolen. During this particular journey, no boxes stolen. But with the tripwire helped us in the sense that we found that the boxes on the top were not secured properly, so they were actually moving around. So the tripwire helped to point that out. And also, I rewind back a bit. So just let y'all know, because we all deal with electronics, robotics, sometimes when we need to bring them abroad, right, it's better to have a official letter from the sponsor or whoever, and to list down exactly what the item's for and what's the purpose in case you get checked at the airport. Yeah. And another precaution that we did was we disassembled everything. We dismantled everything and packed into individual boxes so that it won't look like a bomb, basically. Right? Yeah. So we didn't want to get into a problem. Yeah.
Don't bring anything that looks like some sort of timer, right?
Yeah. So just, useful tips for next time. And then one of the problems we faced was that before we were about to deploy, right, the whole system suddenly stopped working. Then like we were wondering what happened. Then I realized that actually the prepaid value card ran out of value. Yeah, so you need to top up. We needed to top up the value last minute. Then we asked the farm workers to help out because they have a local bank account. So for them, it's very easy to top up. Yeah.
So basically, it works to a certain degree, lah. But as what Ben says, because there's no lost cargo this time round, we don't know whether it actually works or not, right? are they continuing to try as Brian? What's the next phase then? Yeah. So but basically this is an attempt of us on something that we just think from the outset of it how can it work. So we actually came up with a few solutions. We thought of actually the simplest solution most probably is to have some sort of a camera. And every time it stops, the truck stops, okay, maybe by GPS or by some motion kind of thing, and then you take a picture and then send it back to you or something like that. But then it was a high-tech approach was favored more by them because they think that it's cooler. So we also thought that it was cooler. We learned something here.
Yeah.
So we go ahead and do it. But maybe the next time we'll do it, use maybe Raspberry with a camera or something like that, or some sort of a camera setup. And
keep doing. Okay, so this is the data logging for the SD card. You'll log down all the activities. Like every half a minute, you'll tell you where the truck is and whether it's not inside here, but whether the tripwire has been triggered and how long the truck has been stationary at that point. Right. So you can interact with the system in real time by using SMS. Right. The command is LOC for location. So where's your location now? Then you'll send back a link to Google Maps. So when you click on the link, right, you go directly to Google Maps. Then you get SMS alert if the tripwire has been triggered. and you also get SMS alert if the truck has been stationary for more than like 5 minutes. So you know, like some suspicious activity. So we collated all the, we did some data processing, put it into a spreadsheet. All right. Then we also put down all the points where it stopped for more than like 5 minutes. And then so one of the things that we found out from this was very interesting was that the truck company promised the farmer that they'll deliver in 10 hours, but because we were tracking, we found out that it took 14 hours. So it's like 4 hours like more, longer than they promised. So I'm not sure what the farmer's going to do, but it's something that we found out. Yeah, and the boxes were loose. Yeah, and that's our box.
So this is the cause of the thing. You can see the ropes there kind of pulled back by the boxes.
Okay. Oh yeah, so these are just some fun photos. The weather was very cold, they're 14 degrees and we slept in this kind of like open hut. Yeah. This is a pantry area. This is a rice mill where they process the rice. This is the farmer's home. Then they home cooked food. Yeah, then he brought us around the farm as well, look at the animals.
Anybody have any good ideas or whatever like that you want to contribute? Maybe on the next trip, you can connect, you can talk to Arvin and then.
Yeah, okay. The farmer is thinking of a few other projects. Number one is the other one is a weather station. Yeah, the other one that he's thinking about is so in the farm, right, there's a lot of different fields, and the fields are connected via irrigation channel. So the current way of, let's say it rains very heavily, right, you gotta open one of the channel so that the water will flush out. Right now, what they do is they actually go to the gate and dig in. Like that, which is not very safe, especially if it's your dad who's already quite old in it. So right now they are working with University of California or something like that. Yeah, some unit in the US to install the gate. But I don't know the progress when the next time we go. So I mean, if you guys are interested, later you can just stay back, talk to us. Maybe next time if you want to go to a trip like this with us as well. Just
from our point of view, right? I mean, we have very simplistic idea. So no idea is too wild or too simple for us. Because if you have a good idea, we always want to hear you out, I mean, so that we can work together on projects like that. Okay, thank you.
Yes, thank you.